Hi there. I have been hesitating to have this conversation live simply because it's been a little raw. The last few weeks have been really hard. A very dear friend of mine, who I sang about in my TED Talk, who inspired and co-wrote with me my song, I Love You Me, the beautiful Meritxell Negre, the Latin Queen of Soul. She passed away a couple of weeks ago. And it rocked my world. And mainly because she happened to be the first person I met after my awakening out of body experience. In fact, it was actually, it was beautiful and crazy. I'll let you watch the TED Talk so you can hear the details about the out of body experience that happened here in Cannes on the French Riviera. I had been singing in a nightclub and had this bliss experience and even saw a vision of me singing. And I was like so pumped up and like, yes, I've had this vision from God. This is what my life is supposed to be. And so on my way back to America, I left Cannes and went back to Barcelona and went to this open mic night. And I put my name on the list and I'm like, ooh, I know exactly what I'm gonna sing. I was already in my head, like, yeah. And as I'm sitting there waiting my turn, there was this light that appeared. And this beautiful little 5 foot something, gorgeous brown hair woman walks in. And there's a guy behind her. And it's like there is this light around them. People were like hugging them. I was like, who is that? You know, like some superstar had arrived at this amateur like jam session. So I watched them kind of walk in and see the response from everyone. And pretty soon they were called up on stage. So I'm kind of like, you know, nervous already. I'm waiting my turn to sing my song. And Meritxell and Gary Granger, who is an amazing bass player from America, they get on stage and do this amazing set. It wasn't like she just did one song. She came on, and I think the very first song was actually the song I wanted to sing. I know it was in the mix, which was My Funny Valentine. And then they morphed that into Jill Scott, Golden. And then they sang some like 70s song. And Gary's there on the bass. She's doing these amazing vocals. And what was a simple jam session, open mic night, was transformed into this amazing like concert experience. And I remember sitting in my chair going, okay, God, I see why you brought me here. And I kind of started to shrink down. And I'm like, how do I get out of here before they call my name? I'm like, I'm not going to follow that, because Meritxell's voice, it was this silky, smooth, but beautiful, powerful, like the highs, the lows, the range, and then the performance, you know, the dancing, the movement. It was like, I literally felt like God had me in this little place to see how it's done. And when they got off stage, I kind of, again, was kind of like, let me get out before they call my name. And as I was walking out, I passed the bar and they were standing at the bar. And I just said, oh my God, I have got to just say props to you guys, because that was amazing. And they were like, oh, thank you very much. And I'm like, you know, your English, you're not like from around here. Where are you guys from? And they're like, we're from DC. And at the time, this was 2005, I was like, oh, I'm from DC. And they're like, oh, wait, wow. And they were like, well, you gotta come and have a drink with us. And I was like, no, I have to go home because I'm like flying home tomorrow. So I gotta go. Again, I did not want them to call my name. And it was kind of like, yeah, but I ended up staying and hanging with them a little bit. Then we ended up going over to Meritxell's dad's house. So it turns out Meritxell and Gary, they lived back in DC or Maryland at the time. But her family is from Barcelona. And so we hung out all night. We were listening to music and talking and like just amazed at all of the coincidences that had us there, which was another significant thing this month last year. So yeah, we ended up spending this evening listening to music and talking and laughing, and we made a little pinky swear that we would get back together when we got home to DC, and we did just that. We met up. I ended up singing with Meritxell in a number of different places, and Gary. We ended up writing a song together. Back in 2008, I happened to get this music that just inspired this song about self-love called I Love You Me. And I was kind of stuck on the second verse, and I called Meritxell and I'm like, hey girl, let me send you this track. Can you help me out? And she did, of course. Loved what she created, and I was like, okay, let's pop into the studio. And I was like, I'm gonna do the first verse, you do the second verse, then we'll do the chorus together, and had this, planned out. But on the day that Meritxell came to the studio, she had a gig that night, so she only had a little bit of time. So she's like, well, let me pop in to the studio first. I'll go in the booth, lay down my part, and then, you and the producer can work out the rest. Cool. So she's in the booth, looking at the phone because we had the lyrics on the phone, and she's like singing and vibing. And there came this moment where me and the producer were looking at each other like, what just happened? Like, she knocked it out in one take. It was like incredible. And I'll admit, once again, I was like, I ain't going in that booth after that. That's just not gonna happen. And so I literally didn't. Because I was like, it was amazing. I'm like, she just nailed it in one take. So it was meant for me to eventually do the second verse and all of that sort of stuff. But life happened. I ended up moving to Mexico for 6 months, and then eventually came here. So, long and short of it, I kind of for the last several years have been sitting on that song. And not doing anything with it until something in 2018 shifted. And it was like I was getting these messages and messages and messages from within, from dreams, from other people, from psychic mediums, people telling me like, you need to sing. You're meant to sing. What are you doing with your voice? Like all these kind of messages, all the way to when I was in India meditating in this beautiful dome, Baba's room, as they call it. And I got this message from Baba, God. And I'm like, okay, I've had enough messages. I'll do something with it. And so I got this wonderful musician from Romania. What's up, Roma? Who created this music track for me to finally do my part on this song. And so I decided to do that. And while I was like planning to go to the studio, I got word that a friend of mine who also knew Meritxell, who was actually the reason I was in Barcelona in the first place, last February, he took his life. And I was, devastated. Because the last words that he said to me were that he was going to have me singing at his next event. And so when my TEDx came up last year, there was just this message that I needed to sing. And I don't think a lot of people sing for their TED Talks, but I decided to do it. I wanted to honor Dr. T, and because Meritxell at that point had been diagnosed with colon cancer, and my daughter and I had spent a little bit of time with her a couple of years ago, I just decided that I was going to sing, finally, this song, and I was going to do it on TEDx in honor of Meritxell. So I'll let you check out the TED Talk.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, tell me what you see. I see greatness deep inside, staring back at me. What I see is not perfect, no. What I see has flaws, but when I look deeper, what I see fills me with awe. If I start by telling myself I love you, me, I won't rely on anyone else. How much greater could I be if I truly love?
I don't really have any other words other than I pray that both Dr. T and Meritxell are rising in heavenly peace, and that's all I can say about that. But yesterday was Meritxell's birthday, so it has been like really hard, I'm not gonna lie. Simply because I just basically was like, I just couldn't imagine not having her around when I finally do get off my bum to sing. but anyway, I told someone recently that I will not back down. I surrendered when I was in Baba's hut, Baba's meditation room in India, like, okay, if I'm meant to use my voice, then that's what I'm gonna do. I will sing. And so I did this last year for Dr. T on Facebook Live and cried, but I'm gonna take a sip of water and see if I can do this for you and for you, Meritxell. My funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile with my heart. Your looks are laughable, unphotographable, and yet you're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak when you open it to speak? Are you smart? Well, don't change a hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay, little Valentine. Stay. Each day is Valentine's. Stay, my Valentine. Each day is Valentine's Day. Thank you for tuning in. I'm sending you love and blessings. And just to give you a little blessing from the Latin Queen of Soul, here's a little bit of Meritxell.
Somewhere chimney tops, that's where you'll find.